Here we have a regular hexagon. Regular hexagon means all its sides will be equal. You have to note this point, okay? For a regular hexagon, all sides are of equal length, okay? And the next point to be noted is the triangles that you form will be equilateral triangles. Equilateral triangles. Equilateral triangles means all sides are of equal length. So we have to know that the area of this hexagon will be equal to area of triangle PQU plus area of rectangle QUTR plus area of triangle RTS. Now, we have to find out the height of the triangle if we need the area of the triangle, is it not? So, how do we find the height now? We have this whole thing PS as 33 meter given in the question. And this much is given as 17 meter also in the question. Okay. So now the whole thing PS is equal to PM plus MN plus NS. Right. So PS is 33 is equal to PM and NS are of equal height. So I can write 2 PM. PM, PM, 2 PM plus MN is given as 17. So 33 minus 17 is 2 PM. That is 16 is equal to 2 PM. So I get PM as 16 divided by 2, 8. So, I'm getting the height of the triangles PM and NS is 8. Now, what is this QU? This is an equilateral triangle. So, 17, 17, QU is also 17. Same way, RT is also 17. Understand? Now, it's very simple. You just have to apply into the formula. Half BH plus a length into breadth is the area of triangle. Again, here half BH. So now substituting half into, what is the base of triangle PQU? 17, height is 8. Length of the rectangle is 17, height is, I mean breadth is also 17. So 17 into 17 plus half into, base is 17 into, height 8 for the last triangle. Now let's do it. 7 plus 28, 68 plus 17 square. Square for 10 and balance for 289 plus 17 into 4, 68. On adding this, you'll get the area of the full hexagon.